The angles of elevation of the top of a tower from two points at a distance of 4 meter and 9 meter from the base of the tower and in the same straight line with it are complementary. Find the height of the tower. If we observe this problem, the angles of elevation of top of a tower from the two points which are 4 meter and 9 meter away from the base of the tower are making complementary angles. So this is the given problem. So let us visualize this problem first using some pictures. Now we are taking a straight line as the ground. On that ground we are taking a tower. Let us assume the height of the tower as AB, and we are considering two points on the same straight line that they are C and D, and C is at a distance of 4 meters away from the point A and D is at the distance of 9 meters away from point A. And from these two points the observer is observing the top of the cell tower with some angles of elevation. It is given that these angles of elevations are complementary to each other. Using this information, we need to calculate the height of the tower. Now let us see how that one. Let us take the ground, and on the ground we are taking the cell tower, that is AB. So let us assume the height of the cell tower as h meters. Now from a point C which is 4 meters away from the foot of the cell tower, from that point the observer is observing the top of the cell tower with certain angle of elevation, and the next observation point, that is D, which is 9 meters away from the foot of the cell tower. From this point the observer again observing the top of the cell tower with some angle of elevation. Now here these two angles of elevations are complementary to each other, that is given in the problem. So let us assume the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from point C as theta, that is angle ACB equals to theta, then the angle of elevation from point D will become 90 minus theta, since both the angles of elevations are complementary and we know that complementary angle sum is 90 degrees. So now here in this picture we have two right triangles, that is one right triangle is ABC and another right triangle is ABD. Using these two right triangles let us calculate the height of the tower. Now let us take the right triangle ABC first. So observe in the figure, the right triangle ABC, in this we assume the angle of elevation at C, that is theta. For this angle theta we need to find the opposite side of this theta, that is h meters, and we have the adjacent side, that is AC equals to 4 meters. So here we need to take the ratio of opposite side to the adjacent side. So we need to take tan ratio. So let us choose tan trigonometric ratio. So by taking tan theta we get AB by AC. Now substituting the values of AB and AC we get tan theta equals to h by 4. Assume this one as equation 1. Now let us consider second right angle triangle, that is triangle ABD. Now if you observe this right angle triangle, the given angle is 90 minus theta. For this angle 90 minus theta, the opposite side is AB, which we need to find out, and the adjacent side is AD, which we have 9 meters. So again here we have opposite side and adjacent side. So we need to take the trigonometric ratio tan. So let us take tan trigonometric ratio. So So tan of 90 minus theta equals to AB by AD. And we know that tan of 90 minus theta is nothing but cot theta, which equals to h by 9. Now let us assume this one as equation 2. Now by multiplying equation 1 and equation 2, we get tan theta into cot theta equals to h by 4 into h by 9. And we know that tan theta and cot theta both are multiplicative inverses of each other. So therefore their product is 1. So we get 1 equals to h square by 36. On simplifying this, we get h is equal to 6 meters. Therefore the height of the tower is 6 meters.